I look all right? All right, perfect. Yeah, you know, I give all the glory to God, you know, for sure. It's been a blessing, nothing short of a blessing, just to be out there, just running around. I don't even have to get the ball, just running around and just running routes, just feeling love for my teammates. It feel great. Yeah. It definitely, I don't want to keep reliving the experience. It definitely changed my perspective of things, like, you know, hanging around, like, just not even hanging around, but just being around the right group of guys and stuff like that, or being in the right situations, but, you know, just wrong place, wrong time. So just got to live with it. I'm blessed, you know, God blessed me to get out of that situation healthy. I was only down for like a week without just like working out, but after that, you know, I got right back to work and I'm feeling good, so.
How happy are you just to be back, being on the football field, being around the guys, and how is it being around, you know, one of your best friends, CJ Stroud?
Yeah, man, words can't explain, man. You know, CJ been with me since the offseason ended. You know, we've been with each other in L.A., here in Houston, everywhere. So that's been great. You know, that brotherhood is not going to go nowhere. But just being around, like, the whole team, it's been good. You know, we got new faces and them guys cool. You know, we all in there having fun, you know, building our chemistry in the locker room and then taking them to the field. So it's just been good. You know, everybody having fun. You see everybody smiling. You know, we got something special brewing here in the organization, and we're ready to get to work.
That gun violence is a problem across America, and a lot of people deal with it. But when you had to deal with it firsthand, how scary was that, and how much do you feel for other people that have had to deal with this?
Yeah, it's definitely scary, not only for myself, but for my family, because I don't want to put myself in that type of position, and especially, like, my family. Like, I got a little brother, my mom. I know how they was feeling at that time, and it's just a blessing that I'm safe, but it's a traumatic experience.
Overall, how are you just feeling, you know?
Overall, I'm good, you know. I go to church every Tuesday. I pray every night, pray every morning. You know I got God on my side, and that's the most powerful thing to have. You know, I got God on my side. I keep him first in everything I do, so I feel good. You know, I got the right group of guys around me, keeping my head up, my mom, my pops, people back home, like my grandmother, everybody praying for me and just calling me, checking in every day now. Like, they just call. My grandma texts me every day now. Like, it's crazy. But it's like, it's good. I'm good. My mental's right, and I'm just ready to get back to work. Ready to work.
In what ways did the organization support you? And then, second, different question, like, what are your goals? I'm sure you talked about having a fresh perspective. What are your goals for the season?
So, first, shouts out to Nick, D'Amico, my receiver coach, Coach Ben, everyone, they reached out. They was calling when the situation happened, you know. And since I've been hurt, you know, they've been showing tremendous love. Everybody been showing a lot of love and just letting me know, reassuring me that they are right by me the whole time, every step of the way. So that's been good. And my goals, you know, I said it on the podcast. I'm pretty sure some of y'all saw it, but I got some big goals. That's all I'm going to say right now. I got some big goals, and I'm looking forward to stepping in that light and achieving them.
Like being with Stephon Diggs, being around him, watching him operate.
Yeah, me and Diggs, like, this, that's my guy. So, you know, he's been in the league for a minute, and he know the steps to take to get there. And he's been a leader since he came in the locker room, you know, speaking to us and just giving us knowledge, giving us game, you know, pouring back to us and making sure we know the steps to take to get to where we want to go. So he's been nothing short but amazing, the whole group of receivers, all of us. But he's ready to, you know, he's ready to go. You know, he's still got that it factor. And I feel like, you know, with all us coming at the opposing teams, it's going to be special.
How much credit do you give to your trainer, Justin Allen? Because ever since your injury, we've been seeing you work out with
him. Yeah, Jay Allen, that's my guy. I give a lot of credit to Jay Allen. You know, my off times, during the off season, I'm always with Jay Allen. He had different workout plans for me. We go do hill works, outside stand work. In the weight room, we doing explosive things, upper body. We doing a lot of stuff that he putting together for me, and it's for free. So, so appreciate you, Jay. But man, bro, he been amazing, bro. He doing a good job.
Tank,
There's another wide receiver in that, another young wide receiver that's had to handle multiple adversity. Were you able to lean on Mechie through some of the things you've gone through last year and this year? And what have you seen from him and his growth coming back to the
game? Yeah, Mechie, that's my guy. Me and Mechie close. Just me and Mechie, CJ for sure. Like, we always have, like, deep talks. Like, we always with each other. We always have deep talks. And just, like, what he went through, he's showing me, like, life is just, it's bigger than ball. But this is what we want to, this is what we want to do for sure. But, like, when he had his experience with the cancer and things like that, he was just showing me, like, he was telling me, like, it was, like, it opened his eyes way more. And then when I just had that experience, like, it opened my eyes, like, if I want to go, I want to go. I got to cut things out of my life that, you know, so I can achieve what I want to do. So, me and him, we had big talks. But, man, Mechie, you know, he's been doing great. I know if you guys been watching, but he's been putting a lot of work in. He's ready to rock. He's ready to roll, man. He's smiling every day, funny. He's ready to go to work. So, it's been great.
Two things. Going forward, do you plan on doing anything to help other people that might, you know, help them avoid a situation you're in, or is it just something you're going to talk about?
Yeah, me and my agent been having talks about it. So, yeah, I'm definitely going to do something. We can kind of come up with something. Now, I'm not sure what we, like, got in plan yet, but we're going to do something soon. So.
And then now this is your second year in the league. Like, how different is it walking out there with the OTAs, a relationship with CJ, relationship?
Oh, yeah. I wouldn't say I'm comfortable because I'm never comfortable. You never want to be relaxed, but I'm way more comfortable than I was last year for sure. Just like just knowing the playbook, knowing where I'm supposed to line up, knowing where I'm supposed to be, and just going out there to have fun. You know, Coach D'Amico, them harp on iron, sharper iron. So just working hard and having fun doing it, that's the main thing. So.
Have you noticed a difference in CJ as well going into year two for him?
Yeah, he definitely stepped into that leadership role way more than he did last year. Like, last year, don't get me wrong, he was a great leader. But now you can see it, like, any miscues at practice, he's on us. Like, he like, all right, bro, come on. Like, you know, but he's definitely stepped into the leadership role, and he's ready for it. He know we got a target on our back now. Like, last year was a prove-it year, and we still haven't proved ourselves, don't get me wrong. But we know that, like, people is looking forward to watching the Texans play football this year. So, He's not taking that lightly. Like, he wanna give the fans a show. So he's been on us like crazy. So it's been good though.
When it first happened, were you at all worried that it could?
Talking about the shooting.
Yeah, I'm sorry. That it could impact your football career.
Definitely.
And how long till you knew you were gonna be okay?
Definitely. So when it first happened, you know, when I was in the hospital, that's the only thing I was asking. Like, am I gonna be all right to play football? Like, that was my main thing. Like, will I be okay to run and play football like I've been doing? So once they told me, like, it was just like a through and through, like, once they told me that and it was like, you'll be good, I was good. I was ready to go, so.
Last one, DJ.
Obviously, you know, you're from Florida, CJ from LA, but you guys are, like, really, really tight. And one thing that's been noticed is how CJ connects with everybody across the team. How are you and CJ, even though y'all both have different walks of life, have been able to be so tight?
I don't really think we have different walks. I feel like the conversations we have, like, we know each other. So I feel like we both have, like, the same background. Both was doubted, like, from a football standpoint. Both had, like, troubles in our homes coming up. So we connected well there. And then, like, once we just got with each other and we just knew of each other and we started learning each other and talking every day and just going over his crib and watching the football games when we off Thursday night games, Monday night games, and we just chilling with each other. We just started to, like, get that feel for each other, and now, like, we just like this. So it was just like that.
Thanks, Tank.
Thank you.